Ayo, what's up mga guys? Magandang umaga, tanghali man o gabi, saang sulok ka man naroon sa mundong ibabo na ito. O dito guys, at winelcome ni Senate President Mig Subiri, ang Office of the Vice President, siyempre nandyan sa pangunguna yan ni VP Inday Sara Duterte at ang kanyang mga kasamahan sa Department of Education. Alright, pakinggan natin ang ginawang session na ito patungkol sa kanyang 2024 budget at mukhang kinongratulate ni Senate President ang OBP at ang kanilang budget ay sabi nga niya, your budget has been submitted. Congratulations. Oh, ibig sabihin noon, aprobado na ba? Pero hindi maliwanag yung confidential intelligence fund kung nakapaloob pa rin sa kanyang budget. Alright? Pakinggan natin guys kung ano ang mga kaganapan na ito.
Distinguished Vice President Sara Duterte, may silingan in Mindanao. Ma'am, mayong buntag ma'am. And to the whole family of the DepEd community, good morning to you all. So we'd like to recognize a distinguished sponsor, Senator Sonny Angara, and to interpolate a distinguished colleague, Senator Rizal Tadams.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, Majority Leader. We're ready to receive questions. But just for the record, the budget for the Office of the Vice President is 1,874,019,000 pesos. Thank you, Mr. President.
Salamat kaayo, Mr. President. Magandang umaga pong muli. Good chair. And to the OVP, maayong buntag. Mr. President, good chair. In 2022, the confidential funds of the Office of the Vice President were augmented by 125 million pesos from the Office of the President. Now, during the proceedings at the House of Representatives, it was stated that the OVP submitted on January 17, 2023, a liquidation report covering these funds. Currently, the Commission on Audit is auditing the use of this 125 million and has committed to finish by the 15th of this month. Sayang hindi lang umabot dito sa ating plenary interpellation. Pero, Mr. President, good chair, ano na po yung status ng audit na ito?
I'm not sure, ma'am. But maybe we can ask the Commission on Audit when they come before us next week. When they
will do,
that they would be in a best position to answer, Your Honor.
Mr. President, the chair is not in receipt of any initial findings of the COA.
No, Your Honor.
Thank you, Mr. President, good chair. Now, that said fund transfer or augmentation is being challenged. As a longtime senator and as our Committee on Finance chair, ano po tingin nyo, Mr. President, good chair, anong tingin ng good chair, ang pwedeng maging pinaka-prudent na policy kaugnay ng augmentation ng isang budget category na hindi na-allocate naman ng funds in the first place? Dapat bang i-regulate ang ganitong practice o kaya ipagbawal pa natin ng Kongreso?
Thank you, Your Honor, Senator Risa, our Vice Chair and Deputy Minority Leader. Your Honor, what I was told is this was not an augmentation because an augmentation has a very technical meaning in budgetary terms. What I was told is this is a release from the contingent fund, thus not subject to the rules set forth in laws and jurisprudence, which pertain specifically to augmentation of savings, which are authorized to be done by the Senate President, by the Chief Justice, and other officials who are permitted explicitly by the Constitution.
Salamat, good chair. Conceding for the moment na at least sa ngayon, hindi subject or hindi pa subject sa rules at procedures ng augmentation at pinag-debatihan pa nga, di ba, kung augmentation nga ba yung nangyari or ibang proseso. Still, kung hindi pa yung rules at procedures ng augmentation, such a move of big money from the most important office of government to the second most important office of government. Syempre, kailangan siyang ngayon sana o eventually, sooner than later, mag-govern ng mga rules at saka procedures. So, kapag nabuo na or mabubuo na yung rules at procedures na iyon, ano, Mr. President, ang tingin ng good share na dapat maging prudent policy tungkol sa ganyang klaseng augmentation man yan o release man yan, basta paglipat ng malaking pondo mula sa importanteng opisina papunta sa importanteng opisina. Hindi ba dapat ma-regulate yung ganitong practice? Or even, given kung gaano kalabo yung kasalukuyang rules at procedures at given kung paano naging controversial itong mismong paglipat ng mismong perang ito, hindi kaya dapat ipagbawal ng Kongreso?
Sa akin, ma'am, medyo specific na ho yung nasa batas ho natin ngayon. Kasama na po yung mga desisyon ng Korte Suprema, specifically yung Araulio decision. Dahil doon, nakalagay doon na kung ano yung mga patakaran sa paglilipat ho ng pondo. And again, I'm referring to the transfer or not transfer rather, but the augmentation of budgetary items, meaning specifically savings. At doon, pag yan ang pinag-uusapan, yung kategoryang yan, meron ho talagang mga very specific rules doon sa, bukod sa konstitusyon or sa ligang batas, meron din ho nakalagay ho sa mga desisyon. So yung bawal po yung cross-border transfers, kailangan existing po yung budgetary item bago ma-augment siya ng ibang pondo galing sa savings. Ito pong nangyari dito sa OVP, ito po ay release mula sa contingent fund ho, which for 2022 was 13 billion pesos and it's still the same amount to this day. At ito pong contingent fund ay sumasagot sa mga pangangailangan po ng gobyerno lahat po, iba po ang patakaran dito. Hindi po itong ang dahil hindi nga ito augmentation ng savings, iba po ang patakaran pagdating ho sa pag-release or paglabas ng pera mula sa contingent fund, Your Honor.
Salamat, Mr. President. Good sponsor. Kaya nga, interesante at tingin ko rin po importante yung sinimula nating pag-usapan kahapon na simula dun sa kasalukuyang special provision tungkol sa contingent fund na nagpapayag at nagbabawal din sa mga specific kinds of releases. Nagbabawal halimbawa sa paggamit ng contingent fund para sa motor vehicles. Kaya po binuksan ko na rin kahapon, Mr. President, good sponsor, yung posibleng at the proper time pag-amyenda na ipagbawal din mula sa contingent fund ang pag-augment or ang pag-release o paglipat patungo sa CIF ng ibang opisina. At kaya lalo din, Mr. President, good sponsor, yung diskusyon nga natin ay magiging very timely at the appropriate time. Siguro, Mr. President, good sponsor, yung susunod na punto ko, pwede po bang mag-provide ang good share ng mga kahit general details kung paano yung 125 million na iyon ay ginastos, no? Considering yung said amount ay in-expend sa loob ng 11 araw. Malay natin,
mihirit pa rin dito, si
best practices
Madam
ng OVP na yung ibang mga ahensya gamit ito pwedeng pagandahin yung kanilang absorptive capacity considering na yung underspending gaya ng sinimula nating pag-usapan kahapon, major problem pa rin, no? Tulad sa ating diskusyon sa interpellation kahapon.
At ito po yung akibat po nung pag-implement nung yung safe implementation of the programs, activities, and projects of the Office of the Vice President to alleviate poverty and promote the general welfare. At nakita natin nung sa committee, Your Honor, napakarami pong program ang OVP from libreng sakay, yung pagbubukas po ng maraming satellite office, yung pagbibigay po ng tulong sa libing, sa pagamot, sa napakarami po. There's so many services that were provided by the OVP, Your Honor.
So ibig sabihin, Mr. President, good sponsor, yung 125 million ginastos sa 11 o on average mga 11.3 million a day ay ginamit lahat yan para lang ligtas na maimplementa ang mga libreng sakay o paghahanda para magbukas ng satellite offices o magpalibing, magpagamot na itong lahat, yung pagsisiguro ng kaligtasan nito, yan ay umabot sa on average 11.3 million pesos a day, Mr. President?
Yung 11 days, yun po yung period of disbursement ng pera ho. But if you include the period for obligation, it was actually 19 days. And if we look at the services performed or the use of the funds, goes beyond actually the 11 or whether there's 11 days or 19 days. 19 days pertaining to the period from when the SARO was issued, which allows the agency to obligate the funds to the day it's finally paid for, where the services or any contracts are paid for, and thus the cash is considered disbursed. Does not mean that all the services or all the information, for instance, will be given on those days. Meaning, the information could have been given subsequent to the contracting and disbursing of the money, Your Honor. So, tapos yung confidential fund is used to ensure the safe entry for implementation of the programs and, of course, of the Vice President and her staff to various points of the archipelago. For instance, Your Honor, sa Surigao, sa Barm, in other provinces, meron ho talagang mga insurgency dyan. So, kailangan medyo, kailangan siguraduhin na maganda yung pagpasok ng mga programa at saka ng party ni VP, and to guarantee that the program implementation is also always data-driven. So thus, the OVP was able to enter several geographically isolated and disadvantaged areas. For instance, in San Remigio, where they distributed pagbabago bags, school supplies, and dental kits to grade 1 and grade 4 school children in 33 barangays. And the CF is also used for purposes of continuous monitoring and validation of claims, especially for those made in or lodged in the satellite offices. So, sa Bulacan po, for instance, the Office of the Vice President validated complaints that there were persons selling OVP assistance and forms. So, meron hong mga ganong instances na talagang kinakailangan ho.
Sige po, Mr. President, good sponsor. Kahit sabihin natin, for the sake of argument, so ginastos yung 125 million sa 19 days, still, 6.5 million pesos a day iyon. So kahit itanong po natin yung ibang pinagkagastosan nila, information, different provinces or regions, lalo na yung mga apektado pa rin ng insurgency, eh sigurado naman hindi lang yung OVP security ang nag-secure ng OVP, whether the head of office or the personnel or the implementers ng mga programa, pero yung AFP at PNP on the ground. Well and good, data-driven dapat yung mga programa. GIDA areas, ito po ay termino din ng Department of Health. So malamang sa hindi or posible nakikipag-ugnayan ng OVP dun sa mga programa, activities at proyektong iyon sa DOH. Hindi kaya yung mga bags, school supplies at dental kits ay tumatawid na sa budget naman ng DepEd na concurrently hinihead ng Vice President. So claims, various provinces, validation of complaints. Again, still, even with this listing, palagay ko lamang po, Mr. President, good sponsor, reasonable pa rin itanong kung bakit posibleng umabot sa 11.3 million pesos a day ang gastos. And in any case po, just for the sake of thinking aloud, hindi po ba pwedeng i-convert yung mga worthwhile programs sa mga ito into line item sa budget? Mr. President.
Your Honor, actually, the funds were requested as early as August 2022. But the SARO, or the authority to obligate and disburse the money, was only given in December. So talagang, kumbaga, obligado rin silang gastusin yung pera, Your Honor. Kasi kung hindi, di ba we have a modified cash-based budgeting. Pag you use it or you lose it. So, pag hindi mo ginastos yung pera, maaaring mawala sa ahensya mo yon, di ba?
Yes, thank you, Mr. President.
Maliwanag ba, Madam Senator?
Kung ano man, kung yung SARO na-release sa Disyembre, still, kaya...
Kaya nga, bakit in-release? Yun ang tanong. Tanongin mo kay Office of the President. Bakit December na in-release? August pa nag-humingi. Di ba? Kasabwat ba ang Office of the President para pag ginagastos ay kukwestiyonin naman? At nagastos nga dahil nga kailangan gastusin. Oh, di ba? Siyempre, yung mga satellite office, maraming pagkagastusan dyan. Naku po, magkano lang naman yung sinasabi mo? 11 million ilang satellite office. Diba, diba? Kaya yung mga gamit, malamang, doon nag-ano yan. Kaya nga nakapag-provide ng mga satellite offices dahil may perang ginamit. Ganun lang kasimple. Madam, pasok!
Yung interest at yung curiosity ng publiko, bakit at paano nakagastos ng ganyang kalaki sa napakaikling panahon lamang. And good sponsor, were any of the programs that the good sponsor mentioned funded with confidential funds?
Sorry, could you say that? Were any,
of the programs that you mentioned, good sponsor, funded with confidential funds?
No, Your Honor. They strictly adhere to the joint budget circular issued by the DBM and the COA, which lists the permissible expenses for CIF, Your Honor, from confidential and intelligence funds, namely yung purchase of information, yung rental of safe houses, and of course they were conscious of the or items which are not allowed to be spent under the said circular, Your Honor.
So kung hindi po, paano sila pinondohan kung hindi dun sa CIF? Mr. President.
Well, they have regular budgets also, Your Honor, which they can access for they have budgets for MOE, for capital outlay. Those are all at their disposal.
So lalo pong lumalaki yung misteryo kung paano ginastos ang CIF na 125 million sa loob lamang ng 11 araw. Kung hindi man lahat, pero kung marami sa mga binanggit na pinagkagastosan ay kinover naman ng regular budgets. At alinsunod sa utos ng COA, hindi ginastosan ng confidential and intelligence funds. So, salamat po. Salamat kaayo, Mr. President. Salamat, good sponsor. Those are actually my only questions for the OVP budget today. I'll be back at the proper time to propose amendments to the OVP budget for the consideration of the good sponsor and the plenary. Salamat po.
Thank you. Thank you, Your Honor, Vice Chair Senator Risa, and we'll be happy to discuss with you any possible proposed amendments. Thank you po.
Maraming salamat po.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you very much, Senator Risa. Minority floor leader.
Yes, Mr. President, the minority leader wishes to be recognized.
You would like to recognize the minority floor leader, Senator Coco Pimentel.
Thank you, Mr. President, with the permission of our sponsors. Alam niyo po, last year, kasi that this is, I think this the Office of the Vice President last year received the highest ever budget for the Office of the Vice President. So, and this year we're increasing, no? Are we increasing, Mr. Chairman, in our committee report? The bottom line budget of the OVP.
For 2024, it's increased by 30. No, actually, it's in the Senate version, it's decreased, Your
Correct.
Honor.
It should decrease because the Senate committee report.
We adopted the HGAP version, Your Honor. So
did not grant our committee report did not grant the 500 million peso confidential fund. Is that correct, Mr.
That's
President?
Correct, Your
The
Honor.
Effect is that there is a reduction if we compare GAA 2023 to committee report 2024 on OVP, the reduction is?
It's the figure of 2.343 billion minus 1.874 billion, Your Honor. So if the staff could calculate, please. Only Senator Bongo can do these calculations without a calculator.
Anyway, yes, we get the idea, Mr. President. Hindi pala reflected to sa ating summary because we were comparing it with the House version. Apo.
It is less by 469 million, Your Honor.
Okay, sige. So that means we remove 500 and some other items increase siguro most likely, Mr. Chairman, if you can tell us which ones. Kasi by 30 million may nag-increase. It may be the automatic appropriations sa sweldo.
The general welfare of each and every Filipino family. Nonetheless, they will no longer pursue the CIF or CF. And the reason why is because it is seen to be divisive, and as the Vice President, she swore an oath to keep the country peaceful and strong.
So just as I commended the Office of the Ombudsman, the DMDA, Department of Migrant Workers, and the other agencies which willingly gave up their CIF or the CF or did not even ask for these funds, given this latest manifestation by the Vice President, I commend her, Mr. President, for now categorically stating to this House that it's not a deferral to our wisdom. She does not want it anymore, Mr. President. So if that is how I understand the statement, I commend the Vice President.
Senator Tolentino is asked to be recognized. Senator Tolentino.
Thank you, Mr. President. Just a quick manifestation cum intervention again and to remind this committee that I made a continuing manifestation a while ago relative to the existence of the joint circular emanating from COA and various agencies and the possible remedial legislative measure that would enable Congress to comply with the reasonable conditions provided for under the Constitution. Mr. President, perhaps the minority leader, with all due respect, should be reminded that budget proposals coming from the House, going to the Senate may propose or concur with amendments. That would be the operative words coming from the Constitution itself. So it's no longer lodged with the Office of the Vice President, but the decision should come from this chamber, Mr. President, just to manifest that constitutional provision. But we agree that there was a nod, a concurrence coming from the head of the office itself. Thank you, Mr.
Thank
President.
Thank you for that reminder, Mr. President. Although the Constitution is on my desk, I don't think I need reminding anymore, Mr. President. But at any rate, that's the purpose of the budget hearings, di ba? That's the purpose that we make them appear to get their opinion. Because if we flood them with funds, sabihin nila, hindi na namin kaya din yan. I mean, we should get their reaction or their inputs, Mr. President. So, I think that settles it, Mr. President. That's a statement on the Vice President. Tama?
That is
the and she
statement.
Is here, so okay na yun. So yes. That settles everything, Mr. President.
Yes, hopefully, Your Honor.
So again, ano, again, just as kinomend ko yung ibang ahensya ng gobyerno, with that manifestation, I commend the Vice President and the Office of the Vice President. Although last year, because of the, syempre the The budget was the highest ever for an office of a vice president. And then I looked at the programs. Sabi ko nga, parang duplication of some programs of the other agencies of the government. So, the office of the vice president would have to put up the structures the necessary to implement the programs. Kunyari, medical assistance, parang ano din, parang DSW din eh. Educational assistance, parang DSW din, may program din yan. So, siguro, my question now is, kumusta po yung inyong budget utilization for all of those programs na nabanggit natin last year? Like libreng sakay, I think you have a Kalusugan food truck, you have a pagbabago campaign, a million learners and trees, you have a RISE program, relief for individuals in crisis and emergencies yon, and then you have a medical and burial assistance program, you have a magnegosyo taday, that's your livelihood assistance program, and ito bago, parang bago, you can be VP. I don't think I heard this last year, but I may be wrong, but kumusta po yun? Because yun yung worry ko eh. We have hundreds of millions for each program and then they look similar to existing government programs of other agencies. Ang problema, we have to now set up the structure to execute and implement the said programs.
The obligation rate of the Office of the Vice President, Your Honor, is 73%. As of September 30.
Obligation is 73%. Okay, that's obligation. That means the funds are now, anong tawag mo doon? Obligated. So ano na siya dyan? Earmarked na siya for a certain expenditure.
Yes, and the disbursement rate is 84%, Your Honor.
Ano po to? Compare it to appropriations?
Over amounts obligated, Your Honor.
84% of the amounts obligated. And then the 70 plus of the obligation rate is over
obligations over allotments, Your Honor.
Allotments. And then the how much of the appropriations have been allotted or released, di ba? Ganun yun? That's the term. Allotted means released.
Fully released, Your
Honor. Fully released. Okay, po. And then itong ano kasi the Office of the Vice President has been I think has in its plans the construction of the physical office of the Vice President. And is it correct that there is an entry in the unprogrammed funds of 2 billion in connection with what is this the construction of the OVP? Is that the building or the acquisition of the land, Mr. President?
It's for the land, Your Honor, but I think they're still under negotiations. There's still talks ongoing as to, so there's no there's nothing final or nothing contracted out as of yet, Your Honor.
Yes, but it is correct to say that in the 2024 budget there is a 2 billion entry or item in unprogrammed appropriations.
Tama, that is correct, Your Honor.
It's for land acquisition of the office.
Land acquisition, Your Honor.
So if there have been negotiations, so may kausap na. So where is the intended location of the office of the Vice President? May we know, Mr. President?
They're talking to a few, Your Honor. Not just one.
No. So it's still open. So in different areas of the country, no? So we cannot even say if it's in Luzon, Visayas, or Mindanao?
Just in NCR, Your Honor.
It's in NCR. Okay, thank you. Thank you for that, Mr. President. But I think for this year, we appropriated 10 million for down payment. So we have not used this kasi wala pang final contract, wala pang down payment.
Opo. That's correct, Your Honor. Still unutilized.
Opo. And then the Office of the Vice President has its own security and protection group, Mr. President. Am I correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
And I think they have 433 personnel composing this Vice President Security and Protection Group.
Yes, Your Honor.
The expenses for this VP Security and Protection Group are not lodged with the Office of the Vice President. It's lodged with some other agency. Am I correct, Mr. President?
Uh, There is a special duty allowance which is for the security personnel which is charged to the OVP budget, Your Honor.
Which item under, maybe you know under what item and then what is the total amount for that item or is it charged against a program?
Yes, we're just finding out which program, Your Honor. It's charged to the OVP budget. Yeah, there is a, this is the, it's, there's an item for special duty allowance in the amount of 25,308,000, Your Honor.
For one year na po
for,
yan.
That's for 2024, yeah.
Yes, for 1 year, 25 million. Kasi yung bulk ng compensation ng mga security personnel would be found in their mother unit siguro. So, may we know so that when the time comes, may we know from what agencies the VP security group come from?
PNP and AFP, Your Honor.
PNP and AFP. So we'll just ask from them yung siguro yung budget for the 433 regular personnel composing the VP SPG. Okay, so I think, Mr. President, yun na lang po. It's good that the OVP can still efficiently execute their programs, their planned programs, Mr. President. So pero yung pagbabago yata, the plan is a million bags. You want to distribute 1 million bags. That's the long-term plan. What is this for the entire 6-year term? Is that the plan?
Yes, Your Honor.
A million bags. Okay, so at any rate, Mr. President, of course, I also realize we need to give the Office of the Vice President some flexibility in the budget process and some flexibility in thinking of or coming up with programs or PAPs which will make the office more relevant and somehow directly and or indirectly help the constituents of the OVP. So thank you for the patience of our OVP family and thank you to our sponsor for his forthrightness this time, Mr. President. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you, distinguished minority leader, for your kind words for the OVP and also for the sponsor. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Majority Leader.
Mr. President, there being no other reservation for interpellation, I move that we close the period of interpellation and consider the budget of the Office of the Vice President to be deemed submitted for the body's consideration. I so move, Mr. President.
There being no objection to the motion of the Majority Floor Leader, the Office of the Vice President is deemed submitted. Congratulations.
Ayong guys, at narinig naman natin ang interpellation ni Minority Leader Coco Pimentel na efficiently, ang sinabi niya, efficiently ang pag-disburse ng budget ng OVP. Di ba? Maliwanag na walang irregularidad sa paggasta ng OVP. At yun lang, ang ipinupukol talaga itong 125 million na parang ibinigay nga sa August pa inirequest, pero bakit? Yun ang tanong eh. Bakit ibinigay ng December na lang na kailangan ngang gastusin yung ibinigay na yun? Diba? O, hindi, parang ginastos talaga. Diba? Para, kasi nga, kung hindi nagastos, ay kukwestiyonin din bakit hindi nagastos at ibabawas naman sa kanyang budget. Ganon ang mangyayari dyan. Kaya, ito na nga. At congratulate na, deem submitted, ang sabi ni, na-submit na, and for approval na. Alright? Yun ang aking pagkaintindi dyan. Kasi nyo na yan. Kung ano naman ang inyong pagkaintindi dito sa at sinasabi nga yung hindi na ipinupursu ni BP ang kanyang kung intelligence span, confidential intelligence span ay hindi na niya ipinipilit. Nasa sa kanila yon kung ibibigay o hindi, parang ganon. At nasabi na rin ni Coco Pimentel na yun na nga ang sabi ng BP na hindi na niya ipinaporso kung na hingiin ang confidential pan, pero nagmanifest nga itong si Senator Coco, ay Coco tuloy, Senator Tolentino na sa chambers nila, dito sa kanilang chamber, aaprubahan yung mga ganyang budget. So, nasa kanila pa rin ang pagdedesisyon. Alright, yun ang ating opinion dyan o pagkaintindi dyan. Kaya, kung ano ang iyong naintindihan, ay comment mo na lang at pag-usapan natin sa comment section. Alright? Kaya hanggang sa muli, ang iyong kaibigang Roman Carreño LTV, muling magbabalik.